All right, and now we are to Carmen. Had a little trouble finding our wolf, so we're gonna start the video up here. She is the second oldest at age 17. Her story is very similar to Ruby's with the sexuality, but Carmen, you could say, is a little more experienced. I mean, she's 17, she's an older teenager. She's in her prime of her fun and sexuality. She really enjoys flirting with men and getting their attention. Similar to her sister, she's going to try what I called earlier is kind of like a new sin, and she's going to drink beer, as we'll see up here. Because she's more experienced than her sister in sexuality, I'm actually going to compare her story instead of to Charles Perrault, like Ruby's was, and not like the Grimm's, like Robin was. Hers I'm going to compare to Angela Carter. Angela Carter wrote a story called The Company of Wolves. It's really loud. And in that story, well, first, hold on. We're going to flirt by stealing his hat, which of course has a wolf on it. Oh, have fun. Yeah, because we're going to go flirt with a 35, 40-year-old man that's balding. It's a 17-year-old girl, but hey, no judgment. So, in Angela Carter's story, the end of it anyway, she has other wolf stories in there. At the end of it, she has a little Red Riding Hood-based story where Red Riding Hood actually takes control. And, after the wolf makes her strip, she strips the clothes off the wolf so he's damned to be a werewolf for all eternity. And still sleeps with him. And becomes animalistic like him. Interesting. Anyway, now she's going to try beer. And it's going to kick in fairly quickly. Her wolf is this late 30s man who likes to chop trees down. Yeah, if you ever want to read Angela Carter's story, it's a great story. It's very dark, a little gruesome. And Carmen reminds me of that story. Oh, yay, we're so much closer to the grandmother's fence now. Now, I always mention how they look hurt when they walk. Her and her other sisters are clearly very obvious. If you look, her neck freaks me out. See how it wobbles in this very awkward way? And she'll even hold it. Yeah. Kind of like it was chopped off or something. And now we're going to fast forward again. So see you at the house. That's nice. A fan. Well, welcome back to the house. But I saw the fan there. You can hear noises in the background. X's on the doors, just like the trees. I am warning you, there's a little, there's lots of interesting sound effects in this one. That's weird. Sorry, I never saw that wood there before. Probably didn't unlock something. Oh good, I made the fast way through the house. There's a part... Well, I guess I cut it out. I'm gonna need to turn on the fire for that. But there's a part where she goes through and hears lots of saw... You hear the saw going. But you also hear lots and lots of loud moaning. Like I said, she knew what she was doing. And if you don't get symbolism in this room, it's very similar to Ruby's. There's a tree. And a bed. It's like getting cloud. And if you can see her flashes, which you really can't, she's on her hands and knees, and he's smiling and swinging an axe. So, yeah, that was Carmen. That was Carmen. Alright, just a quick note about the last three girls. Since this is for a project, these girls don't relate to any specific stories I know about Red Riding Hood, but they do have their other metaphorical falls from innocence. So they're going to be, we're going to fast forward each one to where they meet their wolf and to their final room or any other significant rooms in the house. So enjoy!